Now, the important thing to remember is never cross the two dielectric circuits when accessing the dual rotoscope. Remember that, Moira. Never cross. That A points to the front. Hand me the neon tweeze, would you? Oh, no, never mind. I have it. Now, pay attention to this next part very carefully. You see this index capacitor? In order to keep a machine as complex as the TARDIS in tip-top form, you must always point A to the rear. Don't ever make the mistake of putting it in backwards, otherwise you could blow a hole in the console, the TARDIS, and possibly even the universe. Are you listening to me? Now see if you can dig out the Ganymede drive for me, please. Moira, the Ganymede drive? Where'd she go? Moira? Moira? Oh, there you are. I've been looking all over for you.
I've been here.
I can see that. You're supposed to be there, helping me in the console room.
I was. There was nothing for me to do, so I told you I was going swimming.
But you just up and left, and there I was talking to myself for who knows how long.
I came here an hour ago.
You did?
You didn't even notice I was gone.
Of course I did. That's why I came looking for you.
And what vital thing do you need me for this time?
My Ganymede drive? Absolutely essential for proper TARDIS functioning?
Never heard of it.
It's gone missing. I had it right next to me.
Well, what does it do? Maybe I can help you find it if I knew what it did.
It drives Ganymedes, of course.
Of course.
This is very strange. Things have been going missing quite a lot lately.
You mean you're misplacing things?
Quite the contrary.
Last night, you forgot where you put the dinner.
I do have quite a lot on my mind, you know. If I forget the odd, unimportant detail, I do hope you'll spare me just a dash of compassion. I thought you were going swimming.
I was.
And why isn't your bathing suit wet? You've been here for an hour, as you say. I would have thought you would have found the time by now. See, I do pay attention to you.
I was just thinking.
About?
About Charlie.
He's a good lad. He'll do fine.
I know he will.
Something bothering you?
Something he said to me.
Oh?
I asked him why he wanted to leave us. He said he wanted to go home before he couldn't go home anymore.
I can understand that.
So, it's just got me wondering. Is it too late for me to go home?
I don't believe it's ever too late for anything.
Have you ever thought about going home?
More than you know.
But it's too late.
I don't think so.
My mom and I don't exactly see eye to eye.
But she loves you and would give the world for you. I saw that when we were last there.
Yeah, I know. But sometimes...
Home is always home, Moira. Even when a bird outgrows her nest.
We landed?
I didn't program the TARDIS to materialize anywhere.
It's been doing that a lot lately.
That's why I was working on the console. Her poor thing is starting to show her age.
Aren't we all?
Speak for yourself.
Well, how about we get something to eat? Then I'll help you with the console.
Well...
What's wrong?
The food distributor isn't working.
Good. Those nutrition bars get boring after a while anyway. I was hoping for something cooked by a human. Or humanoid.
Just what the doctor ordered. We're on Earth. There's a nice alfresco restaurant nearby. Your treat.
Mine?
I don't seem to have any local currency on me.
Sometimes I think you plan that.
Good afternoon. Table for two.
Please.
Right this way.
Can I help you?
Sorry. I just... Sorry.
Looks like you caught someone's eye.
Creep.
Here's your table. Our waitress should be Callie. She'll be by to take your order in just a minute.
Thank you.
Excuse me?
Yes?
Can you tell our waiter that we've changed our minds and are not quite ready to leave yet?
I'll have him bring the dessert menu to you.
That'll be fine.
Are you certain it's her?
Unit 847385. Earth designate, Skye, Moira.
And what's your assessment?
Clearly malfunctioning.
We already know that. Can she be salvaged?
Well, from what we've seen already, I think the choice pretty much speaks for itself. Termination and disposal.
Agreed.
So many good choices.
Stick to the cheaper part of the menu, if you don't mind. I only have American money.
But in the tourist district, maybe they'll take pity on us and make the exchange.
I hope you enjoyed your meal. Please come back and see us again.
Excuse me?
Will you be paying by credit card today?
We haven't ordered yet.
Have you changed your minds? Would you like something from the dessert cart?
We haven't had lunch yet.
Well, then that was a very large appetizer you both had.
We haven't ordered anything yet. We only just sat down.
The lady had fish and chips, and you had steak and kidney pie.
Ew.
That's what you said.
My good lady, perhaps you'll have us confused with another table. We just got here, haven't ordered yet, and in fact are quite hungry. Now...
Sir, I can see the empty plates in front of you.
What?
I don't know what game you think you're playing, but if you intend to skip out on the check, I should warn you that those two blokes over there are two policemen on their lunch. Now, you don't want to cause any trouble, do you?
What is her problem?
You really see empty dishes here?
Excuse me, could you help?
No, we'll pay.
Doctor?
How much is the bill?
£27.50.
I'm not paying for a meal we never had.
You take American currency?
Yes.
I think $70 should more than cover it.
That's all I have.
And a generous tip as well.
Very generous. When it's someone else's money.
Keep the change.
Thank you. I do hope you come again.
Just out of curiosity, could you do me a little favor? Could you tell me what else you see?
Excuse me?
Describe your surroundings.
All right. I see two strange customers in front of me. Over there is Jessica. That table's being cleaned for service. Across the street is a bus stop full of people. The sun is in the sky. The birds are in the trees.
Yes. Thank you. Come along, Moira.
But I'm still hungry.
We'll be sure to recommend your restaurant to all our friends.
As long as they tip well, you can bring Father Christmas for all I care.
That girl's got a screw loose.
Very strange.
You're not taking her seriously, are you?
Shouldn't I?
I think she's waited one too many tables in her life.
I wonder what's happening down there.
What are they doing?
Apparently they're trying to save someone's life.
But there's no one there.
They're apparently loading someone into the ambulance.
The gurney's empty.
Are you all right? I had the green light. What were you doing?
This is very bad.
The light was red. I saw it.
To us, maybe. But to the driver?
What is going on?
We better get back to the TARDIS.
Doctor, wait up!
Miss Skye.
You again?
We need to talk.
You're not my type. Ever. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Command override. Alpha 793. Reboot and initialize.
Would you get out of the way? Doctor! Wait for me!
That was useless.
We don't want to risk creating a scene.
We have no choice. Are we still receiving images?
Intermittently. But they are becoming more and more confused, meshed.
Let's see if we can find out where she's going before we lose complete contact.
And then what? If she isn't responding to commands.
Whatever it is, we need to do it quickly before these humans find out what she really is.
What are we looking for?
Any kind of temporal disturbance. Once we find one, we can attempt to trace it to its origin.
Could it be deliberate?
Anything is possible, though I would think that this is the result of an unintended side effect rather than something planned. The anomalies we've seen are too random to be intentional. Oh, come on, don't give out on me now!
What's wrong?
Part of the main console is failing.
I told you last week that needed work.
Recriminations are for the unproductive. Hand me my toolbox and help me get this system back in order. We'll need it if we're going to trace these disturbances. We need to open this access panel. The fault should be back here.
What happened?
This is impossible. Someone's nicked the entire scanner system.
Thieves? Someone broke into the TARDIS?
Don't be ridiculous.
Whenever you have eliminated the impossible, whatever remains, however improbable, must be the truth.
The Sign of Four, Chapter 6. And don't go quoting Sherlock Holmes at me. I find it patently offensive.
Yes, Doctor.
We'll worry about the missing parts later. The primary console room should still have a working scanner.
Primary console room?
Yes, I've had it closed for redecoration for, well, centuries. Never could find the time to finish it. This way!
Where are we?
Corridor 5A links to hallway 7 Delta 6.
Really?
Cross-section to passage Epsilon Omega 20D, Route 11 Tango Bravo, and Causeway 8.
Sometimes I think you just make things up to keep us poor humans confused.
It's important to know one's home, Moira. Get lost in these corridors and you could spend the next several lifetimes trying to find your way back.
I believe it.
Ah, through here!
I had no idea you had an affinity for flower decoration, Doctor.
This shouldn't be here.
Never been a florist in one of your past lives?
This isn't the time for facetiousness. This shouldn't be here.
A collection of sculpture?
Another hobby I have never taken up. Paintings.
If you didn't do this, then who did?
I don't know. But I'm not a believer in coincidence either. Bits of the TARDIS go missing at the same time we start finding items which have never been here before?
Maybe the TARDIS is breaking down more than we thought.
A frightening consideration. We'd best find out how bad the damage is. The primary console room is through here.
I like it. Very rustic.
A bit cramped for my taste. Now, let's see what we can find.
Doctor, what's happening out there?
I don't know.
Is it an attack? Where is all that smoke coming from?
It's coming from the cars. It's that exhaust.
But so much? It can't be.
This is vaguely familiar.
Can we hear what the news is saying?
I'm trying to tune into one of their broadcasts. See if this is localized or worldwide.
People of the universe, please attend carefully. The message that follows is vital to the future of you all.
Who is that?
It's on every channel.
The message I have for you all is simple. Continued existence under my guidance, or total annihilation.
That sounds like a Dalek.
No Dalek speaks like that.
Then who could it be?
I've heard that speech before.
You have?
I've seen all this before.
Where?
We're going to take a quick hop. Hold on!
Where are we going?
The Pharos Project.
The Pharos Project? Why are we going there? I thought they closed that place down.
They did. Let's make sure it stayed that way. Wait here.
I'm not staying behind.
Two ticks, if I'm not back.
Come and get you?
No, give me another two ticks.
Doctor!
Nothing. Quiet as a church mouse.
Well, anything?
No one's been there in years.
What were you looking for?
My worst nightmare. At least we can eliminate him.
Where are we going?
I didn't do that. Someone's operated the fast return control.
How can that be? We're both here.
We've landed.
Where?
Back where we were, middle of London.
Did something bring us here?
No, the controls were set to bring us back.
Set? By who?
That is the very question we need answered. By whom?
But that would mean someone else is with us in the TARDIS.
Not just anyone. You'd have to be capable of operating her.
Who could do that?
Another Time Lord.
Oh, you mean like the Master? He's here? Or the Rani? Or the Meddling Monk? Or the War Chief? Or...
I can do without the list of psychopaths my race has produced, thank you.
What do we do? Materialize underwater? Open the doors and flush them out?
Wherever did you come up with such a ridiculous idea?
Well...
No. Someone wants us on Earth, so let's go find out why.
Isn't that walking right into their trap?
Of course! What would be the fun otherwise?
What is going on?
Something's coming this way.
A whole lot of something.
I recognize those creatures.
They look like...
Yeti!
London is being attacked by Bigfoot?
These kind aren't native to Earth, Moira. They're from the Great Intelligence, whom I thought had been destroyed.
That doesn't look like any great intelligence leading them to me. Looks like something I've seen before.
You will obey. You will obey.
The Imperial Dalek Emperor? Here?
Obey, or you will be deleted.
I've never heard a Dalek talk like that before.
Neither have I.
All will be subject to my rule. All will be destroyed. Life eternal. Stand by my side and suffer death forever.
Let's see what kind of Dalek this is.
Are you nuts?
Yes. Coming?
Of course.
Halt!
I am the Doctor. I'm sure you know me.
My punch card library has no information on biological unit Doctor.
Really?
We will absorb your light force.
What?
We will absorb your light force.
Since when did Daleks gain that capability?
My punch card library has no information on Dalek.
Excuse me?
Forces, delete Doctor.
They have guns.
Shotguns? Mounted to their arms? None of this is making sense.
Who are you? What do you want?
My punch card library has no information on that subject.
You're not a Dalek. What are you in there?
Yes, let's see who's running the show.
Command acknowledged. Access granted.
Really? I didn't think it was going to be that easy.
I guess it depends on how you ask.
All will be subject to my rule.
Moira?
You will be transformed into the Cyber Army.
It's me!
None shall escape. Earth shall be destroyed. All shall be exterminated. You have always exaggerated your own importance, Doctor. Marusa warned you about that.
Administer anesthetic?
I doubt she'd even respond to pain.
How are you doing these? How did you get here?
It's a future version of the probe.
Everything will be as it shall be.
Stop her!
All the events that need to take place for Moira to turn into yourself have now taken place. You just ordered her to return the Earth to its primary state.
This is a crude method. It may end up killing her.